Know I'm huge about counterflow chillers. Well, Clay at JaDeD Brewing Company reached out to me and wanted to send me one of their products. This is 100% my first opinion and view of the Hydra that he had decided to send me. I told him the brewing configuration, size, and kettle that I use, and he recommended this product that would be the most effective and efficient for my brewing setup. I'm really excited to break open into this box, and I've been waiting to do so I can record it and have you guys get a glimpse of what to expect if you order anything from JaDeD yourself. Packaged bubble wrap around the coils, padded inside the box. The product has pretty much zero to no movement. Bubble wrapped entirely. And best of all, a lifetime guarantee. Alright, let's go over some first impressions. When it comes to packaging, it was packaged phenomenally well. The bubble wrap was around every crucial part of this chiller, including the inlet, outlet, the verticals, and the entire circumference around the main coil. Now, also, he included some heavy duty, like wrapping paper or packing paper, to make sure that there was no movement inside of the box that could basically damage any either of the connection points, the bends in the tubing, or the coil itself. We have some garden hose attachments. We have a female and a male, so you can thread from your inlet and then thread to your outlet to wherever you want it to go. And then it goes in, and then it splits into three individual coils. Now, the idea behind this is to maximize contact surface and sizing and length. It splits into three and then goes out into three and uniforms back into one. There's spacing in between each coil, which is then gonna greater maximize the wart contact that it has with each coil. They're also spaced and gapped pretty damn evenly between each of these three individual coils. And what's cool about this compared to my DIY one or other people's DIY one, there's no movement. You don't see the coil expanding and contracting like a damn slinky. This thing is rock solid. It has some really beefy copy wiring that's securing each coil individually in a manner to where they're gonna maintain their gap so that you have that increased efficiency between the coils. Now, I'm a counterflow chiller guy, mainly because my DIY immersion chiller wasn't as efficient as I'm hoping this guy will be. Also, during the whirlpool on a heavily whirlpool hopped or kettle hopped beer, you have a lot of hop and troop at the bottom of the kettle. When I would use my immersion chiller, I was never able to get a nice cone at the bottom because this guy or any immersion chiller physically is in the way of allowing a cone formation to happen. That is my one thing as I review any immersion chiller, that it's inhibiting a nice cone for you, thus then pick up more wort into your fermenter, because with an external chiller, such as a counterflow chiller, which I mainly use, that's external. Everything inside the kettle is free to form at the bottom and tightly packed into a nice cone so that the edges you can use to be picked up. That is the only downside I see from using immersion chiller, other than my previous worries with them not being effective enough, though I have high hopes for this chiller considering its reputation, and I can't wait to use it on a future batch. Now, I'm really gonna put it through its paces before I end up posting a full-blown review video. I plan to have at least 2 to 3 batches with this chiller before I will be posting a review video on varying sizes between 10 and 15 gallons. I feel like a 15-gallon batch would definitely put this through its paces, considering that's a lot of wort to chill down in comparison to a counterflow chiller, where no matter the volume of the wort in the kettle, it's only chilling the 25 feet worth at a time. so it's all the same whether it's 1 gallon or 100. I'm curious to see the time difference between, say, a 10 gallon batch and a 15 gallon batch when it comes to cooling down the wort when utilizing the JaDeD HYDRA. Before, on my DIY one, me holding it like this, swaying it all about, you would look like a damn slinky in front of the camera. And just by talking to you guys and holding this and moving it, I can really appreciate the sturdiness that this chiller in particular has. I do enjoy the worm clamp, or however you want to call it, hose clamp, that keeps them together. It's probably a good idea to put on any DIY one, let alone the fact that it's on here and very sturdy. Based on my first impressions, I have high hopes for the product. How well it performs is something you guys are gonna have to find out in a later episode. If you got any value out of this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like brewing related content or anything related to brewing, consider subscribing.